Hello, we are discussing about GATE 2005 ECE paper. A double integrator plant, G of S is equal to K by S square and H of S is equal to 1, is to be compensated to achieve the damping ratio of 0.5 and undamped natural frequency of 5 radians per second. So, which one of the following compensator will be suitable? By employing which compensator, you are going to achieve zeta is equal to 0.5 and omega n is equal to 5 radians per second for the given double integrated plant. Okay, so G of S is given, H of S is given. So general expression for the G of S, H of S is going to be, this is the closed loop transfer function G of S and it is H of S. And H of S is equal to 1 means unity feedback system. Plus minus and it is C, this is R of S. So C of S by R of S, closed loop transfer function is going to be equal to G divided by 1 plus GH. Since it is H is equal to 1, you can write it as G by 1 plus G. So G is given as K by S square. So this will be K by S square divided by 1 plus K by S square. So here the value is going to be, you can write it as k divided by s square plus k. Okay. And from this one, if you are equating these two, if you are equating this one to general expression for the second order system, omega n square divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square. This is general expression for the second order control system. So if you are comparing these two things, then S coefficient is 0 and omega n square is nothing but k. Omega n square is equal to k and omega n is equal to root k. Omega n is equal to root k. Okay. So omega n value is root k and zeta value, if you want to calculate, equate S coefficients. S coefficients in general equation is 2 zeta omega n. As there is no S term present in the denominator, we will assume it as coefficient of S as 0. So that means 2 is constant and omega n is also non-zero. So you will get only 0 value if zeta is equal to 0. That means zeta is going to be equal to 0. The present system, the present double integrator plant has zeta is equal to 0 and omega n is equal to root k radians per second. So these are the values. Now you are going to achieve zeta is equal to 0.5 and omega n is equal to 5. So zeta value is going to be increased. So you should improve the damping ratio, because initially it was 0. Now what is the, you are going to get is 0.5. So you must improve the damping ratio, and omega n value is going to be equal to 5 if you choose some proper k value. Okay, so zeta is going to be improved, damping ratio is improved if you use proportional plus derivative controller, that is PD controller, or simply it is going to be phase lead system. If you use a phase lead compensator or a proportional plus derivative controller, then there is a possibility of improving the damping ratio without affecting the type of the system. And there will be a slight improvement in the omega n, so that we may achieve the required value of phi also. Okay. So which transfer function is suitable to phase lead compensator? Out of 4 given transfer functions, which compensator transfer function is going to be resembling the phase lead compensator transfer function? We must know phase lead compensator means, the phase lead compensator is going to be 0 is more near than pole, that is Z is going to be more near to pole. Transfer function is going to be S plus Z divided by S plus P. Okay, where magnitude of Z is going to be lesser than magnitude of pole. So if you are going to write phase angle, then you can write it as tan inverse. S means j omega, so imaginary term. So you can write it as imaginary by real minus tan inverse of omega by p. omega by p. So since z is small, since for the same value of same omega value z is going to be smaller than p, so tan inverse omega by z, tan inverse omega by z is going to be greater compared to tan inverse of omega by p. Okay, z is going to be lesser than p, that means omega by z is going to be greater than omega by p. So omega by z is larger, so tan inverse large is going to be giving higher phase angle than lower phase angle. So lower value of tan inverse will give lower phase angle, higher value of tan inverse will give higher phase angle. So 0, the phase angle, positive phase angle dominates over negative phase angle, so effective phase angle is going to be positive, that means output leads inputs, that's why the name has come as phase lead compensator. Okay, so for phase lead compensator, 0 is more near to origin than pole, so which satisfies this transfer function, that we are going to check now. First come from the D instead of A. A is the right answer, so we will start from the D. Okay, so if you are checking D at the time, pole 0 plot is going to be S plus 6, that is 0 is at minus 6 and pole is at origin. This is not the right answer. Okay, and next, this is, if you are going through this one, S is at plus 6. Okay, so 0 is at plus 6 and pole is at minus 8.33. So if you are looking at, okay, it looks like phase lead compensator, but the 0 must be present on negative half, that is 0 must be present on left half of S plane, but here the 0 present on right half of S plane, so this is not phase lead compensator, remember that one. The 0 has to be present on negative real axis, and by that time the magnitude is going to be small compared to pole magnitude, that is 0 must be more near. It looks like 0 is more near, but 0 should not be on the right half of S plane. So this is also not right answer. And if you are going to plot over here, S will be present at minus 9.9 and pole will be present at minus 3. It is phase lag compensator. So this is also not right answer. So if you are going to check over here, 0 is at minus 3 and pole is at minus 9.9. So which, the only option A is going to be satisfying the phase lead compensator. So the right answer for this question is A itself.